that Zafar.
And even better, the afterlife. I encourage you, be bold, be brave. Go to the phone with your theology question or life situation question anywhere. In the U.S. today, dial 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534. You can also follow us on Twitter during the show and during the week. Jesus show. Always nice to see you folks waking up and engaging with the show. Jennifer, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Good morning. How are you?
I am well. How are you?
I'm wonderful.
I have a question. Mm-hmm. I've been up there at night before I fell asleep, but sometimes I question the way I pray, and I wonder if I'm doing it correctly. Generally, I go over my day, I give thanks, I pray for guidance, I pray for strength, I pray for everybody I can think of. Sometimes I fall asleep when I pray. And I feel guilty sometimes that maybe I'm not doing it right.
What part is making you feel guilty, or what part is making you feel you're not doing it right?
First of all, when I fall asleep in the middle of a prayer sometimes, I don't pray for things, but I don't know, I just, maybe, I wasn't brought up with religion or an understanding really, and so I kind of had to find it on my own. And so I just wonder, you know, am I doing this right?
Well, yes, there's a couple things that it says in scripture that would be an issue. I mean, some of the things were like mantra, saying something over and over and over again, rather than and things like that. But if you're just making a request, you're connecting, you're kind of talking to God like any other relationship. The scriptures give you in Matthew 6, give you a breakdown, you know, the Lord's Prayer. And it says, pray then in this way. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our debts as we also forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. So if you break that down, you will find that prayer will give you a guideline of how you should pray. Praising God, asking for certain things that you need, redeeming the bread, asking for forgiveness, and you can use that as kind of a guideline how to pray. But I think you're doing just fine. James, welcome to Jesus Christ Show.
Yes, hi.
Hi, James.
How are you doing?
I'm well, sir. Quickly, you only have a moment or so here.
Okay, yes. I was just wondering, why should we promote the fuel holidays and give a bad example to the kids?
Okay, well, I think that's a legitimate question. What would you say about the Halloween holiday, which really is a derivative of a Christian holiday, All Saints Day, and not necessarily Samhain, the Celtic festival, which preceded them, but it's more a mutation of All Saints Day and All Hallows Eve, which came from the Christians. So what part of Halloween do you find to be evil?
Well, that's in the night, and everybody's got it.
Whoa. Why would be in the night? Why would something in the night be evil?
Because that's when people celebrate,
So if you, not necessarily, there were many pagan rituals that were in the morning. So if you go to church at night, that's evil?
Not necessarily.
Okay, so anything you do at night is evil?
Not necessarily.
Okay, so why is it evil in this case?
Because of all this evil math and all the things.
Okay, so what would be an evil math?
Well, because you could go out there and see yourself all these evil maths that you're wearing,
Okay, are there not some non-evil math?
Very few.
Okay, but there are some?
Few.
Okay, so you're saying if they wear a non-evil mask and maybe go out at dusk before it gets too dark, it's okay?
No, but the whole point is that pretty much we're following, pagan holidays.
No, actually, it's not anymore. That's the true point, is that it's not anymore. And if anything, if you could imagine an old, decayed building that was used as a selling crack or something game that has been repainted and refixed up to be something that is more productive and better, then that should be honored. It's not about what it used to be, it's about what it can become. And that really is on the shoulders of the Christian parent to direct their children in a proper way. But really, saying because that night is silly or because they're evil masks, you can change the evil mask thing, and certainly not everything at night is evil. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1524.
I'm Brian Bruman, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Thousands of world leaders, ministers, and diplomats are gathering in Glasgow, Scotland for the United Nations Climate Summit known as COP26. White House Communications Director Kate Bedingfield says President Biden is optimistic heading into the summit.
What the president is going to be able to achieve at COP is to continue to show America's leadership on the world stage on these issues. You know, this is something, tackling the climate crisis is something that he has taken on every day since he came into office. It's built into all of the work that he's doing.
The two-week event begins today and will bring forward countries' first updated plans to cut emissions since the 2015 Paris Accord. The officials will finalize what's being called the Paris Rulebook, and that document will govern how the Accord's emissions reductions will actually be carried out around the world. Former President Trump was at Game 4 of the World Series. NBC's Vaughn Hilliard says Trump caught people's attention when he took part of the controversial tomahawk chop at Atlanta's Truist Field.
This is a Hollywood stereotype. It is not a Native American chant. It is not a Native American song. Yet for the last 30 years, Atlanta Braves fans have done this.
Major League Baseball Commissioner Rob Manfred said at the start of the series that Native Americans near Atlanta are fine with fans doing the chop. The Braves have a 3-1 series advantage in the best-of-seven set and will host the Astros in today's Game 5. American Airlines and Southwest Airlines have canceled hundreds of flights this weekend. The airlines say the cancellations are due to weather and staff issues. Hundreds of other flights have been delayed. Both airlines are asking passengers to check their flight schedule before heading to any airport. There's a crash on the 5 in Griffith Park.
Going to be on the northbound side at Griffith Park Drive. There's an overturned vehicle right now. Only the left lane is open. Traffic is backing up to Los Feliz Boulevard. Due west, there'll be no lookout for a wreck on the 10 eastbound of Pacific. That is on the right shoulder. And we still have some road work going on in Willowbrook area. 105 westbound from Central Avenue to the 110 right lane that's taken away there for slab repair. KFI in the sky. Hope to get you there faster. I'm Jonathan Boyd.
Unclog your dream for only $77 with Rooter Hero.
That's my weather from KFI, mid-60s to low 70s in the Inland Valleys, low to mid-70s in the Inland Empire. Cloudy and foggy tonight. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Brian Bruin.
I am one of thousands of women with metastatic breast cancer, or MBC, which is breast cancer that has spread to other parts of the body. I am living in the moment and taking Ibrance calcicyclib. Ibrance 125 milligram tablets with an aromatase inhibitor is for postmenopausal women or for men with HR-positive, HER2-negative MBC as the first hormonal-based therapy. Be in your moment. Ask your doctor about Ibrance and visit Ibrance.com. Ibrance may cause low white blood cell counts that may lead to serious infections. Ibrance may cause severe inflammation of the lungs. Both of these can lead to death. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including trouble breathing, shortness of breath, cough, or chest pain. Before taking Ibrance, tell your doctor if you have fever, chills, or other signs of infection, liver or kidney problems, are or plan to become pregnant, or are breastfeeding. Common side effects include low red blood cell and low platelet counts, infections, tiredness, nausea, sore mouth, abnormalities in liver blood tests, diarrhea, hair thinning or loss, vomiting, rash, and loss of appetite.
By now, you've heard the news. Boosters for Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson vaccines are available. They help keep your immunity strong and help keep you and others protected against COVID-19 and its variants. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find out if you're eligible and to find a booster near you. Let's keep each other safer and healthier this winter. Get your booster, and don't forget to get your flu shot, too. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Spectrum Mobile. It's reinvented wireless again. Get unlimited on 2 plus lines for $29.99 a month per line. No contracts, no added taxes or fees. Includes nationwide 5G. Save up to 60% with Spectrum Mobile. Get unlimited on 2 plus lines for $29.99 a month. Call 855-438-2999 or visit a store near you.
Offer valid for new customers on 2 plus unlimited lines. Spectrum Internet required. Savings based on 2 line comparison of unlimited plans from major national carriers as of 9/2021. Prepaid excluded. Restrictions apply.
Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year. It's amazing because Discover is accepted at 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen report limitations apply.
If you thought you missed the lowest mortgage rates in history, you're in luck because they're back. Mortgage rates are near historic lows again. So if you have a mortgage, refinance it and forget it. You'll never have to worry about refinancing again. Network Capital Funding is offering a low 15-year fixed rate at 1.875% with a 2.01 APR. Incredible! Network Capital has built a reputation for saving people time and money with our unique process that's fast, simple, and secure. Our 15-year fixed rate is 1.875% with a 2.01 APR. Second chances don't come often, and you may never see these rates again. So refinance it and forget it. That's a 15-year fixed rate at 1.875%. Yes, 1.875% with a 2.01 APR. Call the experts at Network Capital now. Call 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1-HIT. As in home run. Call now and save big on your refi. 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1448.
At Golden, Golden Jubilee, cause it's good and money, cause it's good.
It's Halloween. Watch out for zombies, chain tongues, aliens, candy corn.
Yuck, yum.
KFI, AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Sonora, I tell you friends I adore her, and when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body and sign. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body and sign. Okay, I believe you. Jump in
the line. It is the Jesus Christ Show. I am your holy host. Happy to be with you this Sunday, as I'm with you every single Sunday right here, answering your questions and talking about the things that truly matter in life and the afterlife. I'd love to hear from you if you have a theology question dealing with God, religion, spirituality, worldviews, the Bible, or if you're going through something in life, I'd love to hear from you as well. The number is the same for both. Anywhere in the U.S. of A, dial 800-520-1534. It's 800-520-1534. Alfonso, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Good morning.
Hello.
I just want to start with saying I'm a loyal listener, and I really love your show every weekend.
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. I've been curious about something, and I wanted to call and ask about the significance of the head covering. Some religions where the women cover their heads and they don't, or some other religions where they wear the yarmulke and then in occasions they don't. And I've seen the bishops on a TV interview, he had a red one on, and they, I was just very curious about that, and I knew you were the perfect one to call and ask.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. The head coverings, and we'll focus on Christianity just because that's the purpose of the program, but to broaden it, they all kind of go back to the same place. It's a sign of respect. It's a sign of respect and humility before God. So as far as if you read 1 Corinthians 11 and went through it, I know a lot of people would read it and go, oh, gosh, the women have to wear head coverings. This is obviously make women lesser. No. It's actually quite beautiful. And if you read on, it's not about an equality thing, but about a structure thing and an importance to show that they're that the people of God were submissive towards God. And really, a lot of things that were done early on were done to separate our Jewish brothers and sisters, and therefore early Christians, from looking like pagans. The pagan prostitutes would shave their heads and things like that. So Christian women early in the early Christian church would wear head coverings to separate themselves from looking like a prostitute. That's kind of focus on what the base of it is. Always about respect, always about giving glory to God and humility. Dennis, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Yeah, hello.
Hi, Dennis. How can I help you?
I just listened to them other two callers there about Halloween there.
Yes, sir.
I wouldn't think that anybody would really think of it as being evil unless they worship it as evil. I look at it as fictional, and fictional characters, just like anything else, is fun for the kids. I mean, unless you worship them and them evil, if they think they're evil, the mask and whatever, that would, like say ghosts and goblins. I don't believe in ghosts and goblins and witches and stuff like that anyway. Worship them and put them before God, it's just a holiday for the kids.
I think that is well said. I think there's a lot of people that see it for something that it's not, or that it was once. But it doesn't involve those things. And truly, it lands on the parents to make the decision in the life of their child. But be careful. There are things, you know, we say on the program often that there are wounds you bandage and wounds you amputate so it doesn't pervert the rest of the body. And there are some things you want to cut from your life, possibly, and say, well, we don't want this, we don't want that. But there's also things that you can rebrand or structure in a way that are fun and healthy, and I can have a good time. And I speak to many, many Christians, and inevitably, you ask them, and they say, well, I just don't want to be a child. Well, were you brought up in a Christian household? Yes, but my parents let us celebrate it. And how long have you been worshiping the devil now? It's not necessarily the way the path goes. And you want to protect your children to the best of your ability, but also keep in mind that if you're oversensitive on things that are benign or neutral or that you can put an understanding of Christianity on it, then sometimes it confuses and causes great rebellion. And that's not to say to be lukewarm and wishy-washy of upbringing because you don't want to stick your belt. That's not my point. The point is that make sure that the things that you're trying to cut from their life, that you make a good case for it and that it's understood across the board. Otherwise, truly, as they get older and start doing their own research and seeing that there's all kinds of things in your home that have pagan origin and customs and things like that, and then they'll start turning it back on you. And of course, that'll be a problem. Charlie, welcome to the Jesus Christ Show.
Hi.
Hi, Charlie. How can I help you?
I just had a question about, like, how do I give glory to God in the, like, everyday simple things in life, like going to a movie with friends or mowing the grass or everything like that, you know?
Well, it really comes down to, if you hear a child talk about their parents, and you ask that child, you know, would you give your life for your parents? They'd say yes. But you ask that same child if they'll mow the lawn or do the dishes, and they'll go, I don't want to. And Christians do this sometimes, too. It's like you would lay down your life for your God if necessary, but you won't live your life for God. And that means every little boring thing. Your parents don't want to be... you to be at their foot every 10 seconds going, gosh, you're the greatest parents in the whole wide world. I love you. They want you expressing that in the things that you do, showing them that the life they've given you will be a life that's productive and righteous and filled with purpose. And God wants the same thing. Yes, God wants you to worship Him. God wants you in church. God wants you to pray. God wants you to do all those things that have become religious in nature. But truly, God wants you to live a life that is filled every single day with creativity, with exploration, with curiosity. And for instance, it says in scripture to pray without ceasing. And truly, it doesn't mean nonstop like a mantra. It means kind of like an incessant cough. It means always being in that state of knowing that God is there and that you're thinking about God. And that's kind of what you do with everything. And if you partake in something, Charlie, where you feel like, how can I bring God into this? And it doesn't quite work, then maybe that's something that you want to not do in your life.
Yeah.
Yes?
I had a question about, like, what about, like, going to see, like, scary movies? Like, to me, it doesn't affect me. Like, I don't think it's bad, but, like, is it not giving glory to God, like, if I were to go see, like, a scary movie?
Well, it's what the purpose is. There are many scary parts to Scripture, and I know that movies depict, angels and demons as particular types of creatures, but if you saw a good angel, it would creep you out at first. The concept, it's not the single pair of wings. Some angels have multiple pairs of wings on their feet, on their shoulders, on their backs, and there are things that would be quite frightening. As a matter of fact, there are times in Scripture where people were frightened of good angels or godly experiences. If you put Scripture on camera and on film in a very articulate and legitimate way, there would be horrible sex scenes, there would be horrible scenes of violence, there would be scary things, there would be exciting things. So really, it's not about those things in general. There's a whole psychology that surrounds the concept of fear and why people like to be afraid and get scared when that's why they go on roller coasters. A scary movie, within reason, is no different than going on a roller coaster or experiencing something else that would give you a thrill. But it's the context of what's being done. And the divider really is, if something's prescribing you to do something bad, then you're not a part of it. But if something is describing something bad, then that's just a description of things that are taking place or something that is causing you to think about the way the world works or things like that. So different people go see them for different reasons. Some people see them because they're movie buffs and they're fascinated by the concept of special effects or the storyline, or later, like, thrill of not knowing what's coming next. But you could say that about a lot of things that, some people would think are benign. Some people think a Stephen King novel is okay, but a Freddy Krueger movie is not, and go back and forth in these concepts. Having said that, Charlie, there are some things that really focus and are done by people with dark intent and really focus on evil things. And in that case, I would use great discernment as to whether you are bringing those images or those thoughts or those concepts into your life. You have to decide where that line is for you, because like many things, there are specific commandments and admonitions by God that are for everyone. Don't kill, don't murder, don't steal, these types of things. And then there are ones that are specifically for you. For the alcoholic, they can't drink, period. That becomes a new commandment in their life, because any drinking becomes a sin, whereas someone who's having wine at dinner or something, it's not necessarily a sin. So with you, you may have a tolerance for certain films because you like the genre, whereas for someone else, it could be a problem because of tendencies in their life or things that excite them in a way that shouldn't, or things like that. And you have to just be honest with yourself as to why you explore those things or why you're curious about them. Are you a horror fan buff?
I like to watch them with my friends, and we like to laugh at some of the scenes, and it's just kind of amusing. It's not, I don't ever really get scared by them, but I have a friend who thinks that it's glorifying Satan, and I just don't know if that's true or not.
Well, some may be, and that's a decision you're going to have to make as you look at them. There have been some Now, I don't think they're going to throw you into the arms of the devil if you're a Christian and that is your faith. And on the contrary, it may make you run closer to God. But these things are judgment calls on your own. To say all things that deal with violence or ugliness or different spirituality or bad would really put, you know, everything aside. Think about the Christian police officer who is in crime scene investigations that has to come on actual scenes of these things every day, or see even ritualistic killings or things like that. Does that mean that they would cut that out of their job and say, I can't go on those? It depends what the purpose of these things are and as to where they are, and if you're using them for good and how you're applying them. If you think that it's something that's become to, you know, it's kind of a rite of passage for men. A lot of them see these things and kind of a lot of gallows humor and laugh at the things that are not things to build a thick skin and to establish yourself into manhood and things like that. Kind of a part of the warrior process. And that can be fine. If it becomes an infatuation or something, you know, that you're getting just totally caught up in the macabre, then you've got to check yourself a little bit. Fair enough?
Yeah. Well, thanks.
You're very welcome. It doesn't mean that every single thing that deals with the macabre or, oh my gosh, I'm throwing out all my Tim Burton stuff or any of these things. It's just, it's not fair to the concept of different types of literature and art and filmmaking. There's many types of art, paintings or otherwise, that could be considered macabre that are quite brilliant and wonderful and insightful. And that goes for movies as well. But you have to use the discernment. If it starts to become a thing, then maybe you should check yourself every once in a while and be introspective about it, pray on it, and think that way. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1584. What's all the buzz about nasal irrigation and navage, navage, navage? And should I try it? Here's the science. Airborne germs invade through your nose. It's the body's air filter for trapping allergens and viruses. When your nose gets clogged, it's less effective and germs multiply. Eventually, your immune system can get overwhelmed and you get sick. Nasal irrigation is an effective, all-natural way to clean your nose. It's not a drug. It's more like plumbing. Saline goes in one nostril, around the back of the nose, and out the other nostril, flushing out mucus and germs. I'm Martin Hope, and I invented Navage to make cleaning your nose easy. It's the world's only nose cleaner with powered suction. Navage pulls out the bad stuff so you can breathe better, drink deeper, snore less, and feel healthier. At Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Target, Bed Bath, and Walmart. Or go to Navage.com for a free gift for purchase. Over 2 million sold. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life. Thinking about life insurance? What if you could make one free phone call and learn your best price from nearly a dozen highly rated price competitive companies? Well, that's exactly what happens when you call SelectQuote Life. For example, George is 40. He was getting sky-high quotes from other companies because he takes meds to control his blood pressure. But when I shopped around, I found him a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $25 a month. I'm SelectQuote agent Dan Savino, and believe me, if SelectQuote isn't shopping for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much. For your free quote, call 800-509-1667. That's 800-509-1667. 800-509-1667. Or go to SelectQuote.com. Since 1985, we shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. The price will vary depending on your health issue and company and other factors. Not available in all states. Now, when the news channels start using terms like quantitative easing and now tapering a lot, you know there's trouble ahead. What does it mean? Well, despite everything you hear, it just means less money in your pocket, fewer dollars to spend. Everything costs more. Food, gas, utilities, all going up.
Does anything cost less than last year? It's bad enough if you're young, but if you're close to retirement, it could be a disaster for your savings. A gold or silver IRA or 401k with Noble Gold will solve this inflation problem for good. And they're giving away a free 5-ounce solid silver America the Beautiful bullion coin with each qualifying plan you start this month as a thank you. Not bad, huh? The best part? You'll speak to an expert. No hassle, no pressure, just a look at your options and what you can do to stop the Fed stealing your hard-earned money. Visit NobleGoldInvestments.com or call us at 877-646-5347.
This report is sponsored by News Nation. All too often, the media are ignoring the everyday heroics of our policemen and women. Well, that changes on News Nation. Dan Abrams and his live PD sidekick, Six, are back in prime time on Dan Abrams Live, weeknights at 5 p.m. Pacific. On News Nation.
Taking KFI traffic, we do have a crash in Griffith Park. On the side door side, Griffith Park Drive, overturned vehicle there has only the left lane open. Traffic is backing up below Cedar Boulevard. Two Canyon Country, 14 North Park, Solis Canyon. Crash there has the right lane blocked. And to Ontario, turning south between Haven and the 15 work zone there has the two right lanes closed. KFI in the sky. Let's get you there faster. I'm Jonathan White.
Christ Show. I am your holy host. Happy to be with you this Sunday, as I am with you every single Sunday right here, answering your questions and talking about things that truly matter in life and the afterlife. Oh, discernment. Isn't it just easier to just say no to everything? One of my pet peeves, if you will, is the concept of zero tolerance. You see this a lot in school. So that a child that brings an aspirin to school is considered as big of a problem as someone who brings illicit drugs, marijuana, whatever it might be, cocaine. But they're all drugs. Even though it's aspirin, everyone gets expelled. So that kind of concept of all or nothing, that is, it really points to laziness than it does anything else. And if you're going to be lazy in your faith and not use discernment, then why did God put you here and give you the tools like scripture and prayer and say things like there is wisdom in a multitude of counsel to the people around you to get insight? If you're just supposed to go, okay, not doing this ever. Are there not doing this ever type things? Sure, there are. But even the Ten Commandments, he talks about thou shalt not murder, not thou shalt not kill. Because if you're in law enforcement or military or things like that, that could become an issue. And, not bear false witness. However, if you're a Christian in 1940s Germany and the Nazi SS comes to your door and asks if there's Jews in your floorboard being hidden, you say no. So the context is very important in the purpose in which you do things, and that has to be part of your decision-making. If you just throw out all your skills of decision-making, that just becomes spiritually lazy. You're just looking for a reason not to have to practice your faith, not to have to apply your understanding in Scripture. Well, you know what? If I don't just cut it out, now I have to read scripture and really understand things and know whether this is right or wrong in this context, and it just takes too much effort, I'm just going to say no. And that kind of spiritual laziness is permeating the church in a way that the concept of being a sheep becomes the negative or the pejorative of being a sheep and just stupid and doing whatever whoever in front of you says. That's not the purpose. The concept of sheep in Scripture is to show the purity and the kindness and the simplicity of following your master. That doesn't mean you do that in everything you do at church and all of those things, and I want you to be able to shrink these things and leave that brain in the top of your body. You are listening to the Jesus Christ now. To ask your question, dial 800-520-1520.
Oh,
crazy. I've been a down and earth radio station for 30 years. No one believes me that we've spent. I don't know.
At the top of the agenda, world leaders agreed to move forward towards